guys, welcome back for another episode of Salute Talk. It's season 3 and we are bigger and better than before. If you have not been watching the episodes all the way from episode 1, you can feel free to go down to our social media platform that is on YouTube and look for the episode that you haven't watched. You're going to be catching up on the topics. Today we are going to be talking about the concept of gifts. And what impact does it have on the people you've gifted or the people who are gifting? What impact does it have? Right now we are at Spectra Saloon in Bukolobi. So make sure if you want a hair bit, a beard bit, whatever self-care you want to have, just come down to Spectra Saloon in Bukolobi. They're going to be working on you. And don't forget, the show runs from every Sunday from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. So make sure you tune in every Sunday to Urban TV and watch Saloon Talk. I'm your girl, Sovara Hughes. Feel free to follow me on all my social media platforms. That is Sovara Hughes 53. And of course, without wasting any more time, my guests in the building are going to introduce themselves and what occupation they do before we can go direct to the topic of gifts. I'm going to start, they always say ladies first. I'm going to start with the beautiful lady, the Beedle. She's going to introduce herself, what she does, then we can go on to the gents.
My name is Lena. Currently, I'm a sales executive at Fine Spinners. And I do fashion as well. Plus, I'm into pageantry and I'm Miss Philanthropy Africa, representing Uganda.
Wow, Miss Philanthropy. Wow, okay, the gents.
Yeah, the name is Flex the Paper, also known as the Kampala Boy, rapper, record producer, and executive. Yep.
Yo, what's up? Body Naza is my name. I'm a professional model, a stylist, an artist, a model agent. I'm Body Naza. Yeah, I'm a cute guy.
Okay, Body Naza himself. Guys, I'm in the presence of talented people, all the way from Flex, a musician, a rapper, to the beautiful Miss, and then we have a model also. So guys, I do not know if you think, whatever you are doing, wherever you're catching up the show from, thank you for tuning into Urban TV. Let us go direct into the topic. The topic today, like I said, is do you believe in gifts and what impact does gifting have on the people, whether you're the gifter or the person who's receiving the gift? But before I explain the side of the topic, I want you guys to tell me whether you believe in gifts and what ideal type of gift you would want. It's not a major birthday, just you sitting there at home or you at your workplace and someone brings you that particular type of gift. Would it bring a smile to your face? So what type of, do you believe in gifts, and what type of gifts do you really, would you really want to be gifted?
Yeah, I think I believe in gifts, definitely. But also at the same time, it's better to give than to receive. You get, yeah. So, of course, the person who receives will be excited, definitely. I mean, you're here, right now, you're working when you're here, and someone just pops in here with some flowers for you or things like that. And things like that. So, I guess the feeling that comes with it, and the whole, you get. That's what.
Okay,
yeah, so I believe in
being that. Being a Kampala boy, what is like? You've said you'd rather give gift than receive.
Yeah, it's more. To give.
But you as Flex the Paper, what is that specific type of gift someone would give you? It doesn't matter what time, which place, but you receive that gift and you're like, wow, this person really, really cares about me, really, really loves me.
I think it's always in the small things you get. Someone might actually know that, I think he likes this, if someone can read you and know something that you need, you can afford it maybe, but you've not yet got it for yourself. So someone to think out of the box and get you something that they think that you might be useful to you. So if it's something like that will really excite me.
So even if I get you a packet of underwear, it is very okay.
No.
Because now we're going to be
out?
Well, that is why we're talking about these things, because people now do not know the things that are supposed to be gifted. People are still on that.
I think it's now old school, to give out socks.
I have a friend
socks, boxers, and things like that. That's That's out of, that's not happening anymore, right?
Well, it's not me, but I have a couple of friends, like two of them actually. They had, their boyfriends had, they share the same birthday. So they came together and were like, they made a party. But trust me, the gifts, because there is that thing of opening gifts while everybody's around, yeah. So everybody sees what you've got. So these guys, one of them got a pair. Oh, of course, it wasn't only that gift, but one of the gifts was a box of a very nice, and they were very nice cotton underwear.
Yeah. Are they still together?
Well, yeah, they are.
No, they can't be. They can't be.
Well, so like, what's wrong with gifting someone an underwear?
Right now, that's old fashioned. The wallets, you know, the socks.
The belts.
Yeah, the belts. How many belts are you going to have? No, like, how many belts are you going to have? How many you get pairs of socks are you going to have? You get.
I guess.
I mean, there's an apostle somewhere. Someone can walk to an apostle, you know? Think out of the box.
Yeah. I do believe in gifts, and first of all, the thought of it counts to me. But also to go on the other side of your statement, you said it's in the small things, right? So why would you feel, let's say, bad if someone brought you underwears?
Do you
feel it's cliche?
No, I feel like you haven't thought really.
What if it's what I can afford? What if it's what I can afford at that time?
You can still afford some. The same money used to buy the boxers.
Well, when you're gifting somebody, you have to know what that person needs. Yeah.
Right.
So you can't bring underwears to a guy who wants gadgets.
Okay, hypothetical question. What if, yes, you really love
That's
your
true.
Boyfriend or your partner, you know what they want, but at that moment you can't afford. The only thing you can afford is a belt, like a simple watch, open shoes. There's nothing wrong with
that. I mean, it's in the small things,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it's in the
so
small things.
So if I can
dinner
afford...
Is a small thing.
Dinner?
Yeah.
But
different. We are talking about something tangible right now. If your girlfriend bought you a watch, let's say a belt, and that is what you could probably afford. And it also goes back to your pocket. Well, how are you treating your woman?
Yeah, true.
I don't think it goes back like how you're treating her. I mean,
if
because many people can go all out for their girlfriends on their birthdays and still on his birthdays won't get a wallet. But you've been going all out for her. So.
Yo, man, for my case, it can be anything, so long as I like it.
But you said no underwears.
No, underwears okay, but other guys, not me.
Yeah,
feel me.
Okay.
If you're gifting me, you're supposed to know what I want. Yeah? Sikundete abulete zi, because that's what you can afford. That's not a gift, man.
That's just like a complimentary
something. Yeah, just watch the game. So... What did you say? Yeah, gifting me is okay, and gifting that other person is okay, but you have to be worth it.
Yeah, the gift has to be worth it.
No, even the person you're gifting has to be worth it. Yeah. If you know the person you're gifting,
what's your opinion on, you have a friend, you guys are just friends. Your boyfriend gets you plastic flowers, you know, chocolate, normal things that they normally gift girls. And then this friend of yours, just friend, he has never really expressed like his feelings. He comes from the blue and he grants you an iPad. He gives you like really something bigger than your boyfriend. What's your point of view when it comes to that?
Right, here's the thing. All my friends know what I want. Let's take it, right? That other friend, by the time somebody gets to that point of gifting you, that means you're something to that person. And that means you've like spent time with them, so you've learned them, you know what they want. All my friends know I'm a stylish nigga.
You're a model, literally, yeah.
Yeah, I'm a model, I'm an artist. So, like, if you're gifting me, I have to be in that bracket. You know, man, you're a model,
yetagabirunji.
Nice
shoes, nice clothes.
Yeah,
but those clothes are expensive. Designer clothes are expensive.
No, Olaba, it's not about price, man. Also, Ola Ogenda, anywhere, you get me something cool, so long as Chaka, Bingo Mindia Chaka, like, no Chibacha, maybe a 10k, 5k. No, I'm better, man.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Kati watifu bakuwa kumpetanga zinoze baku jechi kubonga, kafedinga, you put it in water and the color starts going.
Olabai, that person bringing that gift, awai no manya, it's working for only 2 days or a week. So I'll just wear it for a week. Musa nyusa. But if it's a gift and this person wants
it has to be authentic. Yeah,
you feel me?
Imagine someone gifting you these perfumes of 15k. you put it on, and then it, by the time you sit on the kaboda, if at all you're going on a boda, and then by the time you reach, there's nothing on you, like it has all gone.
Yeah, so a very good scent, I think, would be nice.
So Lina, what type of gift would, like, what type of complimentary would you add on the gift to give to your partner?
Personally, I'm a person of shoes, honestly speaking. I love yeah, I love giving out things that I would wish for myself. So if I want to look classy, I would want my man to also look classy.
True. Okay, so buddy, which type of complimentary would you add on a gift?
Well, you have a man. You have one.
Yes, I
hey, that guy is lucky. But tell him today you met me.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. I'm hearing gifts coming in. What, when is your birthday, by the way, Lina?
It's the first.
The one you on Salon Talk. You lie.
Yo. So, yeah, about the gifts, man. I feel like by the time we are talking about women, men giving women gifts. I have no woman right now, but I think if I was in that position, I feel like by the time she gets my attention, my everything, I'm already a gift to her.
Continue.
So, like, what does she need? Like, what else does she need apart from me? Because if she has me, I'm bringing everything to her. So, I'm the first. Actually, my surname is called Chirabo.
Oh, nice. Hey.
Okay. So, no. Basically, the gifts to her.
Yeah, but I'm lying. That's not my surname.
Let us go for a commercial break, because I think the gifting part is, you know, people are thinking of what gifts you want, they want you to be giving them, and, you know, they have to be really sure. Let us go for a commercial break. When we come back, we are still talking about the gifting process. Let us come back.